Hello everyone, greetings to you wherever you are. Welcome once again to my channel Tamu's Farm. Please don't forget to like, subscribe and share this video to any poultry farmer who wants to take his poultry record keeping digital. Okay, so this is the digital record keeping spreadsheet. It's actually an Excel sheet, so only that we've made it very user friendly and then easy to navigate with all these graphics and all that. So let's begin with feed estimator. This is just an overview of a projection of how much you're going to spend on your birds. So let's say you have to insert your number of birds. If it's 2000, you insert. If it's 100, you just insert. If it's 300, insert. So whichever number you want, you just insert it. Then the program gives you total daily feed. Let's go with a bigger number. Let's say 2000. Okay, then it tells you that total daily feed is 24 kilo, total weekly feed is 168 kilo, and the number of bags here is, we are assuming every bag is 50 kilo. So here we have 3.36 bags, or let's say you should be buying 4 bags for just a week, and then you name the type of feed here. Mind you, this is not fixed. You can insert your own type of feed there, because some people start with chick mash anyway. So you enter the price and then you get the cost of the feed in total for that particular week. Now for you to know, let's say how many bags of the broiler starter you are going to buy, you just highlight this and then you come down here, then you see the sum over here. All right, then the same applies everywhere. So once you enter the price of the feed, you also get to know, once you highlight this, how much are you going to spend on broiler starter. Once you highlight all these ones, you have your sum figure down here, which is 3480 cedis. Okay, so, and it runs through from age 1 to 80. I remember somebody once requested that we do it up to week 80 for here. And so we did it. So, but basically the calculation of every other thing is from week 1 to 20. So you don't have to worry. So here you list your, what do you call it, your vaccines that you need, list them and their prices and the quantity you need. Of course, you should know that. So once you enter that, you'll be able to know the cost of your vaccines and medications. So for medications, you also list the all the necessary medications that you will need. All these ones, you can decide to add your own, because I know people do coryza and all that. So you can also decide to add the ones that you have, then the coccidiostat, pure vitamins, antibiotics, and of course the dewormer. Let me just add it, because it's needed, the dewormer. Let's say you need a total of 2. Wow, this shouldn't appear as Ghana City. Sorry. Let's make it general figure. Okay. So, unit price. Yes. Sorry. Unit price should be in Ghana City. Okay, so all these are supposed to be in Ghana City. So you just enter the price of the antibiotics. Let's say 120. Once you have a hashtag like this, it's not an error. It simply means that the colon is too small, so you have to increase it. Take notice. Let's say your pure vitamins is 80 cedis, and then your coccidiostat is 200 cedis, and probably your dewormer is 50 cedis. You just enter them, the quantity that you need. Let's say 2, and then this one is 2, this one is 2, this one is 2. Just assuming. So you enter that in you that you're going to spend like 900 cedis on medications. Then the total number of bags from week 1 to week 20 that will be needed for your 1,000 beds from week 1 to week 20 is 313 bags. An average cost of feed per bag. Once you enter those figures here, if you remember, you'll be able to get the average here. So you should do your findings and get the current prices. That should help you to know how much you'll be spending on feed. So the total cost of feed for your two, well, how many bears did we insert? Okay, so total number of bags or bags for your 2,000 bears and the cost of feed for those 2,000 bears, and then total cost of vaccines and medications here. It should be cost of medication and vaccine. Okay, so total cost of medications is around 1,200, and then the cost of day old, I assume you bought each one at 14 cedis, so it should be 28,000 if you are running a 2,000 bed. Okay, so the total cost of rearing is 100,000, and then the total cost of rearing per bed is 50,000. This just helps you to know the worth of your of each bed once you are producing them. So then the same thing applies for broiler broiler production. So let's get to broiler production. Okay, so you just also insert broilers are up for 9 weeks. I did this danger because from 6th, 7th, 8th week, you should start marketing them. Okay, so you also insert the number of broilers you are looking to raise. So once you insert the number, it tells you the average daily feed per bear, total weekly feed per bear, total feed to be consumed for that week, average body weight targets for each week as you raise your bears or in kilos. The number of bags here shows you that for 500 they would consume one and a few bags. Okay, so it continues on the cost of the feed, and the total cost of feed is just like the other one. Once you know that one, this one will be easier to also understand. And then let's come here. Okay, so it runs through in the same way. It runs through like that everywhere. Okay, so we are done with that, the rearing period. Then let's go to the daily records. So for first batch, now this is something I want you to take notice of. Once you get your sheets, first thing to do, you can decide to rename this one the first batch, but I think for easy recognition's sake, for maybe your first batch is Lohmann, you can decide to name them Lohmann whites from, let's say, Ken Bieber, right? Or if it's from Miracles or any, maybe Top Man, you can just name it in order for you to easily recognize it when you come. So, number of beds. Also, the second thing to do is enter your number of beds. Then the breed, of course, if you want, you can enter. Then the arrival weight. Most people ignore this, but it's needed if you want to really monitor your birds each week. All right, so once you've entered this, the next thing to do is to enter your date of arrival over here. So let's say they arrived on 30th June 2022. Once you enter, all the dates will automatically line up for you to be able to. Whoa, how has this one changed? Lohmann White from Ken Bieber. Okay. Then that is it. So you just start entering your data, mortality on arrival, let's say 1. So it calculates, maybe you've killed 2 and all that. So type of feed, you enter the type of feed, then the total daily feed given, let's assume you gave 32 kilo. Then average weight at the end of the week, maybe when you weighed them, each bird was weighing 60 gram. Okay, so the water intake, then medication given, then vaccination, right? This place is for egg production, but you know definitely that you are not going to be entering egg collection here. So that is it. And once you also get to your egg collection period, let's see how that one also looks like. Okay, so you have total crates for the day. Let's say you have 12. So you calculate, and then maybe you had a surplus of 5. So everything calculates for you. The percentage, the total number of eggs, and then even the total number of crates. And maybe out of it, 10 was spoiled. So then it starts calculating everything for you. Let's say the next day you had 15 crates and then 7 surplus. Then the spot X were 4. Okay, then you have 15 crates. So as you keep doing this, let me enter some more data because I will need it when we get to the data analysis. Is this 18? Okay, 6. Spot X 2. Then 20, 12. Let's say 8. Let's say the next day you move to 25, 14, spot 8 again. Okay, so this should be enough. It should be enough for us to know. So the same thing applies for all the badges. Once you enter the number of birds, you can change the name, then the name, the breed, and then also the date of arrival. Very, very important. It's very, very important. Okay, then you keep recording your mortality, as I said. Then second batch, the same thing, only different colors have been used, so it doesn't change much. Okay, so then let's come to chart and data analysis. So here, once you see, I enter some figures, so now the graph has started really. So once you enter for, let's say, up to be 44 or so, you realize that it will keep updating the graph to match with what you are recording on the farm. So sometimes you see that something happened. Hey, I noticed a drop here. What happened anyway? So then we have, this is for those of you who don't have this feature, don't worry about it. This is a new feature. Then we have production dashboard. Production dashboard shows you the progress or what is happening or the performance of each batch all on one page and in a simple table called pivot table in Excel. So once you come here, you have okay, this is the first batch. Okay, so first of all, what you do, close these ones. If you are just entering yours, I'm just showing you how to do this once and for all. Come to analyze and then you refresh. Good. So once I don't know if you noticed it. Once I refreshed, those crates that I entered appeared. Okay. If it's not up to date, you have to come here and make sure all these ones are checked. All these ones are checked. Like the years. Okay. So it shows you that the average percentage is 2% for October. Okay. But once you've been able to complete all that of 2022, it also gives you the summary in a simple way over here. So number of crates produced. So here, managers can use to answer simple questions like how many crates were we able to produce in 2022, October, November, December, blah, 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 blah. And what was our production rates averagely? How much production rate were we getting? So this gives a full picture to either the manager or the owner what is happening at the farm. Same thing applies to second batch, third batch, and fourth batch. Good. So another thing we want to look at is the egg production projector. Good. So here you have something like this. That let's enter our 2000 bears. This used to be a separate program, but I decided to add it. So you enter the number of bears. Sorry for this small font size, it needs to be increased. Okay. Right, so with again, you enter the cost of feed, enter the best cost of the old chick, and it gives you that. So average meal prepared to point of there is 5.36. Then approximate feed consumption, blah blah blah. You enter your average cost of feed for, let's say, 250. That is a combination of chick starter and grower mash. So the projected cost of feeding on 2 points of lay, then approximate estimated total startup cost, which is for feed only. So over here, you can just say 60,000 based on what? Oops, 60,000, not 600,000. Okay, so projected daily feed consumption. So this is the daily projection. Projected daily feed consumption during peak laying would be, let's say, 90 kilo. Then projected number of bags to be consumed for a day. If we are looking at 125 gram per bed, is 1.7 or 1.8 bags, which is almost like 2 bags a day. Okay, so then you enter your projection, enter your expected or projected production percent. So let's say you're looking at being able to produce 80% every day, or let's say 75% every day. Did it change? Oops, what's that? Right, so if you enter, let's say 75%, you have 1,500 eggs a day, which is equivalent to 50 crates a day. Then we have the pricing and sales. This is where a farmer can decide to price his eggs in a way that he can earn enough profit to. So let's say unsorted. Unsorted is usually the average price. Or let's say if you want to go by grading, you have to always use a medium size. So let's say you are going to be selling the medium size at 26 cedis. So projected daily income on egg sales is 1,300. Projected weekly income is 9,100. So then you enter the cost of feed per ton, right? Cost of feed per ton, which is equal to 20 bags times the price of layer mash. So let's say if you are mixing a ton of feed for 4,500 or 4,520, then it means that this one will last for 11 days if you are doing 1,000 best. Let's change that number, 2,000 best, sorry. Right, so once you enter the number of bears again, you have entered average price of egg. Where were we? Okay, so it shows you that for 2,000 bears or for 1,000 bears, a ton will last for 8 days. Okay, then the total number of eggs to be produced per ton is 200. Or crates, sorry. You're supposed to get like 200 crates per ton for 1,000 beds. And then the sales income per ton here is when you multiply the number of eggs to be produced after mixing a ton times the unsorted price. So the direct profit per ton here is, sorry. You have 680 cedis if you are selling. So here, if you want more profit, you just have to increase your price. And then you can see your profit margin will increase. You just have to keep playing around with this to know how much you really need in order to run your farm, how much profit you need to keep your farm running. So number of bags, so this is monthly production. The number of bags for the month will be 75 bags. So number of crates to be produced for the month here is 760 crates. Then total sales income will be 20,000. Then cost of feed for the month is 13,000. Then monthly gross profits, excluding operational costs, is 6,600. These are just That's why I always say it's 90% accurate. It's not 100% accurate. This will all depend on the figures at your end. So then you enter cost of labor, the cost of transportation, and all these things. Then at the end of the day, you have projected total monthly profit of 3,600 for 1,000. Is it 1,000? What did I enter here? Okay, for 1,000 bets. So if you want to know for 2,000 bets with the same figure, you can run through and check the figures. You can also target 80% average production, right? So once you enter this, you are get. So you see what has happened, 80,000, and we've increased to 12,900. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is basically how the spreadsheet works. If you need a copy, just follow the description. My WhatsApp link is in.